today we're going to be doing our Q-tip pointillism landscapes. For that, you're going to need a pencil, a paintbrush, some Q-tips.
Yep.
A cup for water and fill it up with water. Watercolor set or colored markers or acrylic paint. And the first thing you're going to do is draw out the landscape that we have here. I have attached another demo for the sketch of this landscape on the PowerPoint. And once you've done that, then we can move on to our dots. And if you're using watercolor, you're going to use the brush to dip in the water and create a nice puddle of color that you can then dip your Q-tip into. We're not dipping our Q-tip into the water and then going into the watercolor. We're going to use a brush first, dip in the water, and then kind of wet up your watercolor so we can dip right into that. I'm going to start with our water area. So I'm going in with the blue. And I'm going in rows from left to right, because if I started doing it at the bottom and then tried to do the top, I might smear it, so. Now, if you have another blue in your watercolor set, like you have two blues or you have a different color blue in your markers or acrylics, you can fill in these spaces, white spaces, with that secondary color, or you can just fill it in with the same blue that you just used. I'm going to use my other very used watercolor set because it has a darker blue, just to show you all what that looks like. Little friend who likes my painting. If your color starts to get a little wet, like mine did here, it is also helpful if you have another sheet of paper and you can dab it off a little bit before you put it on your actual painting. It takes some of that liquid off so it doesn't drip everywhere. Now we can move on to our grass and ground and tree area. And for the grass, I'm gonna use yellow and blue. And with pointillism, putting two colors that we would usually mix together creates sort of an optical illusion where your eyes would see blue and yellow as green. Because if you mix yellow and blue together, you get green. Now this watercolor set has a yellow, but it's very pale and hard to see. I'm going to use my yellow from this watercolor set. If you have a secondary yellow, you can use that. If you don't, then you can just use blue and green next to each other. But I'm going to do yellow and blue just to show you all what that looks like. ground area, and this is going to be yellow and this orangey sepia color. Again, if you don't have the yellow, if your yellow is not bright enough that you can see it, you can just use this color. Take your time. If a certain area of your paper is not fully dry yet, you can wait until it's dry. I know I'm going a little bit faster, but that's just for the sake of this demo. You all take your time. And now we can move on to our trees, and I'm going to make the bottom of the tree that same orangey color and the dark brown. I'm going to go in with my dark brown first. Now going in with the orangey color. We can go in with the leaves, and I'm gonna do the blue and green method just to show you all what that looks like and see the difference. Go in with my green first. Every time I change my color, I have to re-wet my brush and re-wet my color just to make sure that it's still wet. My blue. Making sure that this area is still wet and not sticky. And I'm also reusing my Q-tips that I already have the same color in. Unless it starts to get really stringy and I can't use it anymore, then I'll switch it out for a new one. Now, before I do the boat, I'm gonna let this area sort of dry a little bit more. I'm gonna do the ground and then the bushels. And for this one, I'm gonna show you all what it looks like with just the orangey color instead of mixing it with yellow and the orange. Since it's just all one color. now I can move on to the boat. For my boat, I'm gonna have it be brown with red and orange sails. So I'm gonna do the dark brown first. Lastly, we're going to do the sky, and this is just going to be blue, but I'm going to keep it a little airy and light and leave some of that white space. Since I can't use white on white paper, you won't see it. I'm just going to leave these little spaces open, but just with one color blue. So I'm going to wet it a little bit more. Go for it. And since some of the areas on your paper still might be wet, I'm gonna turn my paper around. But I don't risk smudging anything up here, which means I'm gonna be going from right to left this time instead of left to right. There we have it, our Pointillism landscape. Isn't that beautiful? Well, I hope you guys enjoyed this little activity this week. I'd love to see what you're doing or any other variations that you might do of it. If you have a giant tree in your backyard or a tree at your nearest park, you can do your own sketches of landscapes and do your own pointillism paintings, and I'd love to see them if you decide to do that after you're finished with this one. Okay, hope you guys liked it. See you next time.